You're next in line for the official Holiday World Podcast.
Welcome to Holiday World in Splash and Safari.
Dropping in from Santa Claus, Indiana.
Riders will experience swift acceleration, high-speed turns, and sudden stops.
With park president and CEO, Matt Eckert.
Other things randomly drop off on my calendar, but this never does.
Vice president and COO, Matt Bloomhart.
Geese are like the worst.
Media relations manager,
Sabrina Jones.
Oh boy, hot take.
Director of entertainment and events and fourth generation owner,
Lauren Crosby.
I do what I can. It's a podcast.
And director of communications and fourth generation owner,
Leah Cook Bloomhart.
I do a terrible job as a podcast host. Someone should fire me.
Now stow your loose articles, buckle up.
And please keep your hands and legs inside the car at all times.
And we're back. Welcome back to Season 5 of the official Holiday World Podcast. This is Season 5, Episode 24, the one with artificial snow. Today is Monday, December 4th for us, but we plan to release this episode Monday, December 18th. Welcome back, Matt E.
Hello.
Sabrina.
Hi.
Lauren.
Hi.
And Matt B.
Merry Christmas. Almost.
Not yet.
Yeah. It's December 18th.
The listeners are getting us on the
next week. Yeah. Is Christmas.
Is this will this be the last episode before Christmas?
Yes.
Okay. So Merry Christmas.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's
Merry
right.
Christmas.
He's right.
All right. I want to welcome our special guest, Andrew. How's it going?
Hello.
Hey there.
Andrew's really excited, in case you can't pick up on the tone of his voice.
So Andrew is the star of our Hard Hat Chronicles this year.
Andrew doesn't like to be pulled away from his work.
He's the director of projects and planning, and he also was the star of our most downloaded podcast episode to date.
Dang.
Wow.
Welcome back to the table.
Released in the new season since we've been going. The other ones,
we can't trust those numbers.
The numbers before were different. but the one with where we bleeped out all the useful information from the interview with Thanksgiving sounds, that was our top downloaded episode for the year, for sure.
So, I wonder what the...
How proud are you, Andrew?
That's really awesome.
Was the next episode our least downloaded because people were so mad they didn't listen again, or
probably.
Did they come back?
It was a drop.
Yeah.
Bless those interns.
Yeah.
That was the intern interview one.
Oh.
We love you, interns. All right, so we've got Andrew on today because Good Gravy right now is rocking and rolling.
Good Gravy.
Yes, it is.
So, Andrew, tell us what's been happening out on the site.
So we are on day 8 of ride install. So our friends from Vekoma and Northwest Coasters all arrived last Monday and started working very hard. Had a good week of first week. We had some, got the track put in the station. We got started our lift over the weekend, where we're now coming out of the building on the lift side, which is really cool to see. Then we worked our way out through the cranberry can, out of the station on the other side, through the cranberry can. We're wrapped around the playground when I left site today, and putting Ooh. Final touches on for a crane to be on site tomorrow. So tomorrow we're going to put the lift in, all the track on the lift side of the station, and work our way back over to the gravity side past the playground. And I think if we're going to cross our fingers and say by Friday, we should be putting our last piece of steel up.
I know where I'm going to be hanging out tomorrow.
Yeah.
Taking 200 or 300 pictures on my phone.
I'm going to be bold and say there's no other park that will ever talk about going through a cranberry can.
Yeah. We had the
has to be.
Antoine from Vekoma, who our Vekoma rep, I asked him, I think he said this is his 40th year working in this
wow.
field.
Holy cow.
And I said, now, but have you ever put a coaster through a cranberry can? And he had not. So
that's first for him.
Yes.
What a proud moment.
Yes. We put our stamp on that.
And you said that the sculptures will be going in as well.
Yeah.
Around
yeah.
This time. The
milk bottle and the rolling pin are slated to go up this week.
They look awesome.
They do.
They do.
Look really good. I'm excited to see them in the air. But the final sculptures will be here in the next couple weeks, and those should be going up as well. So
nice.
Cool.
So by December 18th, when this releases, we should be completely done with track.
We should be completely
That's
done with
crazy.
Track.
Yep.
Putting
That's
the final,
crazy.
Final touches. Vekoma's here until the 22nd. So
okay.
They'll be finishing up on some things in the station that no one will ever see, but have to go in and hopefully – getting ready for the new year.
It's moving along fast. I suppose it's not the longest coaster in the world, so it will move along fast.
So then you're not going to have anything to do after December 18th? Is that what you're saying?
Can check out.
Yeah, definitely.
I can get my list back out.
I think if everyone here can put their list away till at least January, we'll be good. I was really impressed. So the last 2 months I've stood in the station looking at where we're going to come out to go to the Cranberry Camp. And like, man, it's going to be really more dynamic than what I think we originally thought. And now that I see it and you're actually going uphill to the Cranberry Camp, I'm excited. I want to ride.
So based on the timeline, when do you think the first time will be we can run it?
When you say we,
when is the first time that it can be ran?
Yeah, Vekoma will probably run it the last week of February.
Last week of February.
Okay. Yeah. It's probably going to be cold.
Yes. I don't think there'll be a long line that week.
Refreshing.
People wonder, I bet Blue Mart will be out there.
I feel like, I don't know, it'll do fine. It's not going to run as fast when it's cold, but...
And it's Indiana. It might be 75 degrees.
Yeah.
It's not like the Voyage, where when we start it up and it's chilly out, you know, or we do a lot of track work, mm-hmm. we're crossing our fingers and doing everything we can to make sure the train makes it all the way around. I don't think we'll have that problem with this ride.
Yeah, I don't think so. I think it's going to be more about the people on it are going to be chilly.
Yeah.
The physics of it kind of guarantee that it's going to come back.
Right.
That's what I was wondering. Yeah. I was like, is it kind of designed to...
What goes up comes must come down.
It should. Kind of thing.
I've got a question. So,
the presentation.
Which one of the theming props, like the
sculptures,
which one of them is the tallest? Is it the Whisk?
Yes.
Okay. Cool.
One is 13 feet tall, one is 15 feet tall, and one is 20 feet tall.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's pretty big. Andrew's been anxious every day.
Every day, yes. But the rolling pin and the milk bottle are both sitting out where if somebody's not paying attention, they could get a scratch. And I don't want to deal with that. So
and there's a lot going on out there.
Yes. Yeah. There's
a lot of people moving not parts paying attention. In a lot of different directions.
Midway's getting poured tomorrow. The slab for the addition's getting poured on Wednesday or Thursday.
Hey, when you say nice. Midway, you're talking that connects back into the Mayflower mm-hmm. Midway?
Yep. Yeah.
Cool.
Nice. Yep, that awesome. Expansion. So that's a lot exciting. Of people on site.
I like seeing it on, like when you see, look at it, it's amazing how it really truly is a full area. Mm-hmm. I don't know, like other rides that since I've been here, like it's a ride and like it's a part of the area, but like it adapts to what's around it, where this is like we've created a whole area. It's mm-hmm. really neat.
Yep.
Made life really easy for Andrew.
Yeah.
No, I'm excited about it.
Do it all at once.
Yeah, and when you're standing out there, I stood out there before any track was installed, but you started seeing support columns go in, and it, you know, it's a family coaster, but when you're standing out there in the Stuffing Springs area, I think the ride's really going to have some larger scale.
Yep.
When you're standing in the middle of it.
Yep.
Well, Andrew, you said before, but that turn coming out of the station, I think it's going to be surprising and pretty dynamic.
It is. And then there's a lot of those turns. When you turn back mm-hmm. around the playground and then you go up and down and you turn around the food truck area, there's just a lot more dynamics there than we realized. Or then it looks on the video. But then when you're standing out there, well, to Matt's point, now that the playground's up, you kind of envision it. Mm-hmm. Like, there's a lot going on here.
Mm-hmm. And then you have a crane coming on site, right, to do the mm-hmm. higher sections? Mm-hmm. Explain how that's going to work.
So tomorrow we'll be able to set up in one spot, and all day tomorrow we'll have the lift. I think by the end of the day we should have the lift pretty much buttoned up. So then Wednesday we're going to move over to as close as we can get to the playground and set as much as we can from there. With all the rain, it's going to make it kind of impossible to get over there. On the grass, so we'll use a crane for that, and then later in the week we'll move over by Mayflower and set the final pieces.
Cool. Will the I know there's a maintenance catwalk that goes up the lift. Does that get put on after those track pieces are up?
That was all pre-assembled. Okay. So that's what they worked on today and yesterday, pre-assembling all of that.
So that's already attached to the track.
And cool. And then they just have to make connections in the air with the crane and the man lifts.
Neat.
That's cool. Yeah.
They've been busy out there they arrived.
One of the things that I hadn't thought about, because obviously all the animations and renderings we have are in the daytime, the lighting over there mm-hmm. that I've seen like at night is really cool. Yeah. Like mm-hmm. it's really, I don't know. It's the most modern piece, I think, of this. It's because it's very minimalistic, but everything has this really neat glow. Like everything in that area has got a really cool glow, and I really like the lights.
Yeah, the lights towards the end of design, we took a different approach there. We used a new firm, not real familiar with the park from a design standpoint. So I saw that light fixture and called over there, and we were talking through it. I felt like it was going to be a very expensive light fixture because when you look at it, it does look so modern, so futuristic. And it almost didn't make it because we thought it was going to be too expensive, but it was not. It was right in line with where it needed to be, and I'm really glad we kept it because I think it looks good.
It looked really nice. Yeah.
When even the lighted poles over by, well, yeah, the sculptures are all going to be lit, which those, you know, those up lights are really cool. Mm-hmm. But even the lights over by the playground, like the shorter ones, like the playground is very well lit for nighttime. I really like it.
We're set up for success if we ever decide to have evening hours again.
Well, you know, Halloween
does get dark. Yeah, you're right.
It'll be really nice during those Halloween late nights.
I think the coolest light's probably going to be the cranberry can light.
Oh, I'm so excited
for that.
Is there
a light inside of it?
There is, and it's red.
Oh,
that's fun.
We're putting the top on the cranberry can tomorrow, so it's going to be cool to be able to see that light and see how it performs. I think it's going to be cool.
That's cool.
Well, Andrew, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you all. It was fun.
Go get that ride finished so we can experience it.
We will do
so we can add more projects to your list.
We've got them.
Yes. Yeah.
You've got more stuff to work on. I know.
Andrew will never be bored.
But thank you for spending a little bit of time with us today.
Thank you.
All right. Since it's December 18th, we have to do one last shameless plug for last minute Christmas ideas. So right now we have our holiday promotion. Steven, do you happen to remember the promo code?
Why, yes, I do.
We didn't even practice that. That was...
You betcha.
That sounded very game showy.
It sounded like we were prepared for it. Nice.
You just go to holidayworld.com/save, type in promo code SANTA100. You get 2 any day tickets for $100. Back to you, Leah.
And that is up to 8 tickets per purchase. So that's a great deal. And that goes through December 31st. So if you want to surprise some friends or family members with a visit to Holiday World, still available. You can purchase season passes online still. We have a little pillow box that you can download and print with a little card that says somebody bought you a season pass.
That's the gift that just keeps on giving.
Yep. I'd say stocking stuffer, but I don't think anybody's putting something as expensive as a season pass in a stocking.
Right. But photo passes and games playbooks make wonderful stocking stuffers.
Moving on to History of Holiday World, or Hi-Ho-Wo.
Hi-Ho-Wo, hi-ho-wo, whoa.
I missed it.
What?
Hi-Ho-Wo, hi-ho-wo.
There we go. I pointed at her and she's like, what?
It's okay. I put it in every time.
I was going to say, it was in an episode where she wasn't
down seriously?
Here.
Oh, yeah. I put it in every time.
Yeah, he's got the clip.
I have it saved as Hi-Ho-Wo Stinger just for Lauren. Yeah. Clearly, it's in every time.
Clearly, I don't listen.
Well, this year I thought it might be appropriate to take a look back at when we did used to have a Christmas event at the park for Santa Fest. So this comes from the Evansville Courier and Press from November of 1991, written by Roger McBain.
And shout out to him. He did a lot of coverage of us while he was with the Courier. So,
I mean, 1991, I was 1 year old, so.
That hurt.
It's okay. Alec, how many years old were you?
Or how many years old
negative
was he 10. Not?
I was negative seven. -7.
I'm done.
That's worse.
I'm leaving.
I tell you, Alec, though, you blink and then all of a sudden you're like the middle group. Middle group. Because I remember. Yeah.
I'm just happy to be in the middle of the pack.
Yeah, I'm in the middle of the pack. Yep.
Same.
Holding solid right there. Feeling good about it.
Actually, I guess I'm young side of this room.
Yeah.
That's weird.
Guess what that makes me. Awesome.
old. Holiday World's 1991 Santa Fest season opens Friday, but the festival's musical drama, A Christmas to Remember, will get a preview performance at 7 p.m. today in the theme park. Proceeds from tonight's performance will go to Street Relief, a not-for-profit organization that aids homeless people in the tri-state. Admission to the preview is $10 per person. In the play, presented annually as part of Santa Fest, a widowed grandfather spends Christmas with his grandchildren. Instead of store-bought gifts, he presents personal mementos and the stories that give them value. The drama, which includes traditional and contemporary holiday songs, will play twice daily during Santa Fest, the theme park's annual Christmas celebration. Times will be 12:45 p.m. and 3:30 p.m. Central Standard Time. I love the specificity in this article.
12:45.
After opening Friday, Santa Fest will run through December. In addition to A Christmas to Remember, the event includes a new attraction, sledding on manufactured snow. This is why the title is the one with artificial snow. Also because we never have a white Christmas here. Almost never.
And what sounds more fun than sledding on manufactured snow?
I like it's manufactured, not artificial. It's yeah. Manufactured.
I should change the name. The one with manufactured snow. Weather permitting, park patrons will be able to slide down three hills of man-made snow, two 300-foot runs, and a gentler 70-foot run on sleds provided by Holiday World. In addition, the park will offer a dozen other rides, strolling carolers, and the Dickens-esque humor of another theatrical production, The Tales of Thaddeus P. Appleby.
That's a name.
Yeah, it is.
Wow.
Food, Christmas decorations, and gifts are available from Holiday World concessions. The park will be open, this surprised me, from 11 a.m. until 4:30 p.m. Central Time Friday, and then Saturdays and Sundays through December 22nd, except December 14th and 15th, when it will stay open until 6:30 p.m. So that means there were like two evenings. In addition, the park will be open December 26th through 31 from 11 a.m. till 4:30 p.m. Admissions to Holiday World will cost $6.95 during Santa Fest. Children two and younger will be admitted for free. Group rates are available. The price of admission includes sledding, a dozen other rides, and entertainment. For more information about tonight's preview or other Santa Fest programs or daily snow reports on Holiday World Sledding Hills, telephone 1-800-467-2682 or locally 937-4401.
Was your mom one of the carolers then?
I believe so.
I think she was.
She was in some form of entertainment during Santa Fest.
Yes.
I think
even,
it was
even with me being born in 90, I think she participated in some.
Yeah, I think
there's pictures of her in the book.
Yes.
Was it A Christmas to Remember, I think was the name of one of the shows. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And then the carolers.
Yeah, I think she was one of the carolers.
Yeah.
Dad, I think, filled in as one of the carolers.
Really?
Yeah.
I feel like I remember seeing a picture with both your mom and dad as carolers.
We don't just make pizzas around here.
I remember a very adorable Lauren Crosby baby picture in that batch. Just a little blonde. Yeah.
Oof. I would have been like...
Were you on a sled?
You three? Yeah, you were a little nugget.
A little nugget.
I feel like somebody at one point we had talked about the sledding, maybe during our 75th year, and somebody had written back and was like, why don't you bring that back? And the answer is...
Many reasons.
Mm-hmm. Many reasons.
Right.
The first of which is the sledding hill is now the Raven exit.
Right.
So
it's a very steep hill to be sledding down. I don't know about that.
Someone last week...
That was pre-lawsuits era of the United States. Just...
I don't know about that hill for sledding.
Have to have a really long field
to burn off all the energy.
Like, well, you just end up in the dive pool. That's all.
Yeah. No. Or no the poles.
I'm good.
I actually had someone text me last week. They were like, we think this happened. We think we remember sledding at Holiday World, but... Was that a thing or a weird dream that we had? It's like, oh, there's no way we would do that now. Yeah. But yes, that did happen.
The only hill steeper would be the dam on Christmas Lake.
Yeah.
That's a pretty steep
hill. Yeah. It is.
Did you guys sled down that as kids?
Yes.
Was there a long run out to burn off the energy or did you ever run into a tree or anything?
That's a pretty wide open field there.
Yeah.
The playground wasn't there back then. So
Polar Park wasn't there.
You could run it out right there.
Okay.
But yeah.
And most of the time, you know how like the dam in Christmas Lake Village, there's like the first hill and then there's like a second little thing.
There's a very
most
straight
of the time,
patch before
you were
the second
lucky
hill.
If you could make it to the second hill.
Oh, it was really? Always it was always the goal. Yeah. You yeah. always tried to get going fast enough to hit the second hill. And if you hit the second one, you're like,
glory is yours forever. If you could hit the second hill.
We always funny when he said the dam, I immediately went to the one over by right. Lake Rudolph. And I was just like, there are trees everywhere.
That is not advisable.
Wrong one.
Yeah. There's the raven and lots of trees.
All I have to say to this is there's a podcast that I listened to with a comedian that always uses the phrase, local jokes get local work. And I feel like that's what we're doing.
Fair enough.
Welcome to the Christmas Lake Village, not even Santa Claus, Christmas Lake Village podcast.
Eckert, whenever you were growing up, did you guys sled at your house?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like, so my husband's from the same area.
Yes.
And discussing sledding with someone who grew up on like Mount Everest.
We had massive hills.
Yeah. And he's like, then sometimes you'll hit like a cow petty and you'll take off. And I'm like, this is like, were you wearing helmets? Like,
I never did that.
Yeah. He said like every now and then, like you would hit something that was frozen.
Yeah. I would say it'd be frozen.
Yeah. It'd be frozen. Yeah.
We didn't sled where there was
cows, animals.
Dung there.
You just liquidated them first.
Yeah.
Just made sure there weren't any around.
We steered clear of that.
This took a real turn.
Right. But yeah.
As our podcast typically do.
We live really close to the drive-in, and they're like me growing up, we had to pull our sleds four-wheelers because there are no hills at all. There are no hills. And there's one in Rockport, and it's like half of what they are in Du Bois County. He's like, that is so sad. I'm like, oh.
No,
flat.
For us, like, my grandma and grandpa lived up on a hill, like, from our house. So we could literally sled from their house almost down to ours. Like,
wow.
Yeah. That's pretty cool.
That's awesome.
It's like hill country.
Yeah.
Want to make a suggestion or have questions for the Pod Squad? There are more ways than ever to reach out to the podcast.
Find at Holiday World on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and use the hashtag HOWOPO to let us know you're talking about us.
You can now call us. Dial 812-937-4401 and type in extension 8081 to get to the HOWOPO voicemail box.
Leave your questions and feedback for us there, or you can email us at podcast@holidayworld.com. either with a written message or with a voice memo.
Again, reach out on social media to @HolidayWorld and use the hashtag HOWOPO or call us at 812-937-4401, extension 8081, or send us an email to podcast@holidayworld.com.
Want to know a secret? The best time to buy season passes is always right now. It's that simple. We believe in transparent pricing, so there's no game to play and no complications. Prices increase throughout our off-season, so hurry and buy now. We have three different passes with different perks, so go to holidayworld.com/passes to pick the pass that fits your family best.
We are Holiday World, and we love holidays.
We sure do.
December 18th is Baked Cookies Day. Do you have a favorite type of cookie to bake?
As much as I bake, I don't bake a lot of cookies. Snickerdoodle is probably my favorite.
Ooh, yeah.
Okay.
Those are good.
I'm more of a cake and muffin baker.
And cupcakes.
And cupcakes,
do
yeah.
mean icing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I like making the Toll House cookies.
From scratch.
That's Matt's expertise.
Like, from scratch.
The square ones.
Or the slice, the log. Is that what you're talking about?
No. The pre-cut squares.
The pre-cut ones. You gotta do the pre-cut ones. They taste better. And they're easier.
That manufactured. Yeah. Mm.
Honestly, though, whenever I do them, I roll them up in a ball. And I'm telling you, they do not taste as good as when you just leave it in a square.
Just leave it in a square.
Really?
It's designed that way.
It's science.
It turns out to be in a circle by the end of it.
It is culinary science.
Yeah. I will tell you, though. But it stays nice and thick in the like towards the middle because it's got that square shape. It, like,
You're not wrong. I just made some of the square sugar cookies with my kids over the weekend because I didn't feel like doing the whole like from scratch thing. That's that's reserved for Santa.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Santa
sure,
gets scratch
sure.
cookies.
Obviously.
But we did those, and I will tell you, though, so I made half of the package on a cold baking sheet, like just room temperature baking sheet. The second time, like, I let the cookies cool little, and then took them off the baking sheet and then used that same mm-hmm. warmed baking sheet to make the second. They turned out so much better than the first.
Hmm. Really? Mm-hmm. Good to know.
So what's the science behind that?
I feel like there is something about like making cookies on a warm baking sheet.
Hmm.
I feel like I've heard that you're supposed to actually do that. I could be wrong.
Well, I might warm mine up the next time.
I advise that you try it because it like started to like smoosh out a little. Like, yeah, before mm-hmm. I even got them in.
Oh.
But they still like, they turned out really good, like perfectly soft.
Hmm.
Okay.
Insider tip. I'm doing good if my cookies make it to the sheet, if I'm honest. I just like eating it.
I did sneak a square of cookie dough into my mouth. I wasn't about to let my kids in on that secret right. yet.
Yeah.
You didn't get salmonella or whatever they
it
say.
Says, it says bake or eat like from the
certain ones now.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Do say bake or eat? Yeah.
Yeah.
Wonder if they're egg-free or something.
I don't know.
I think that's what's supposedly dangerous.
Never heard of anybody getting sick from that anyway.
Made from powder.
It's all a lie.
Right.
I think it's like something the parents told their kids because they didn't want them eating the dough.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I hate to say it, but one of my favorite sweet treats of all time is just plain cookie dough.
Yeah.
I don't want to mm-hmm. make.
Yes.
I don't want to put it in the oven. I just want to eat cookie dough. Or like any time mm-hmm. during college, I felt like I would get like the log and then me and my friends would all just like slice it off and it dips and eat cookie dough like cookies because they're already shaped in that log circle form. Man.
I feel like
I'm making
I would...
cookies tonight.
Yeah.
Chocolate
No,
chip.
You got to wait till December 18th, man.
We can do it again then. Yeah. I feel like, though, is some of the joy gone if it's safe to eat?
Right.
I feel like some of it is some of the fun is the danger.
And I'll say too, I love the ones that are, if they do make it to the sheet, the ones that are kind of basically dough in the middle.
Yes.
There's a place in Evansville.
That's
just
what I'm saying.
Rennie's.
The square does so well. Oh, just Rennie's.
Oh my goodness.
Cookies.
And they're like doughy in the middle. I'm excited. There's a new one in Santa Claus. A new cookie company I saw. I'm excited to try theirs, too.
I haven't tried them yet. Yeah.
I don't like sugar cookies, but I love a Holiday World sugar cookie.
Mm-hmm. I love our snickerdoodles.
The big
have you
ones?
Had our snickerdoodles?
I have not had our snickerdoodles.
Our snickerdoodles are so good.
Come out the big ones?
Yes. Yeah. Any of them.
I made the mistake of eating one of those in one sitting the other day. It was a very bad decision.
That's a commitment.
It was a good decision at the time.
In the moment, yes. Yeah. But immediately afterwards, I was like, that was too much. I went too far.
All right, December 19th is National Hard Candy Day. Do you have a favorite hard candy?
I like hard candy a lot. It makes when I see that, it reminds me of like when I was younger, my grandma had like those canisters of the striped candy ribbons that were like 17 pieces stuck together.
Yeah.
Because they've been there probably since 5 Christmases ago.
And her house
but
is like
80. But she still liked them.
Mm-hmm. Our grandma was because her house was set on 80, like
probably.
365 days of the year.
But that's what I think of when I see that.
I was really pumped we sold that in the park this year. I love that we talked about that on
I
the podcast.
Some. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. I like Jolly Ranchers a lot.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm a Jolly Rancher guy.
I feel like had one of those in a
hard candy time. Makes me think of Werther's, and I do love some Werther's.
Ooh, yeah.
I love Werther's. I'm not joking. I probably have like 5-10 Werther's a day.
Okay. So, wait a second.
I'm an 85-year-old woman.
Wait a second.
Alec, that's
where are
a
they
problem.
Hidden in your desk? Just asking, just out of curiosity.
I have this bag on my desk and I'm out right now, but every time I go home during lunch, they're sitting in my cabinet and I'll grab like a fistful of them.
That
they help
awesome.
Me like not snack throughout the day.
I feel like there's rehabilitation programs we need to be looking at for you.
Oh, that's great. Werther's are good.
All right. December 20th is Games Day. Great day to purchase your games playbook. Sorry, shameless plug. But also, favorite games. I'm very excited because I intend to introduce the Crosby children to Yahtzee this year for Christmas.
Fun. Ooh, that's fun.
I got them kids Yahtzee, Star Wars version.
Fun.
Don't play this around them.
I don't.
What do we get you?
Yeah, we actually got a couple of games for Thanksgiving. I know it's you don't get presents, but we were all going to be there, so we were like, hey, let's play some games.
Yeah.
So we got the Ransom Notes game, which is hilarious because you have to, you just get a handful of random words and then you have to make up a response to a particular prompt, like you got to tell your mom a reason that you didn't get the job or something like that. And then you just have to use the random words,
the words that you have in your collection.
That you have. The other one was Puns of Anarchy. And that one is...
I own that, I think.
Oh, it's from the same people.
The dry erase marker with it? Yes.
Yeah.
I can't get anyone to play it with me.
Oh, man. My kids are so in it. They love it. But those are a couple of good ones that we just got.
Okay, I'm adding that Ransom Notes game to my Amazon list because that needs to happen.
I feel like Chardy Party is my other one that, like, I loved the one time we played.
It was great.
That's fun.
I just can't convince people to easily play it.
I love it. I've overheard my nieces and nephew and with playing Life with my kids, and they got into a giant argument over my niece trying to sell her husband on Life. She's like, what do you mean? She's like, these rules are terrible. And I'm like, why are you trying to sell your spouse? Like, you can't do that. She was so upset. She's like, I can sell a house. And yeah, I'm like, but you can't sell it. Yeah, it was a whole deep dive. Let it go, man.
Not property. We decided a little bit ago, I think.
I was like, no, ma'am. She's like, then I'm just going to kick him out of my car. I was like, that's fine. You can do that.
Yeah. All right. December 21st is Don't Make Your Bed Day. I don't know about you. I'm not making my bed most days.
We don't make our bed. Yeah.
maybe I'll do the reverse.
I actually half made it yesterday.
I noticed.
Why?
Because we just got our
room
back. We've
been doing home renovations.
So I was like, nice. I wanted to make a little bit of an effort to keep this organized.
Yeah.
And then you didn't make it the next day?
No.
I make the bed.
Of course you do.
Us, it's like a loud.
Is that like the first thing you do when you get up?
No, because I wake up like way before Michael ever gets out of bed. So I have to wait. And then I live a whole life in the morning and then I go back and make the bed.
I live by a hard and fast last one out rule. If you're the last one out, you have to make the bed.
Yeah. Yes. If I did that, it would never
get never
made.
Get in. I understand
so
that.
So what do you do in your second life in the morning? Like, well, you have another job or something?
Basically.
Or side hustle.
I get up, I listen to podcasts while I get myself ready. And then I go upstairs and get the kids up and I get them dressed and brush their hair and their teeth and get them downstairs and make them breakfast. And then normally, like, while they're sitting there eating breakfast, I'll run into the bedroom and then I'll make the bed and then I'll come back out and make sure they're still eating and get a so we're all set for school.
I'm exhausted just listening to that. Do you take a nap in between your two lives? Or?
I do not. That's why I'm always so tired.
I'm tired.
December 22nd is National Cookie Exchange Day.
4 days after National Cookie Day?
Are we going to bring cookies?
Yeah, you're going to exchange
it's the reject cookies.
Right. I don't want these anymore. Here, you can have them.
3 days before Christmas, too.
I was going to say, I'm like, if we actually were in the office like that close to Christmas, I feel like that'd be a fun day to celebrate.
Right.
Where we could all bring in our favorite types of cookie.
There you go.
You know what, though? I forgot to mention on Baked Cookies Day is Mom's Cookie Canes. Those are some really good cookies.
Canes?
Cookie canes. Mm. They're like a kind of oatmeal cookie.
Yeah.
Like oatmeal sugar cookie.
So she makes those every year at Christmas? Like, is that a multi-year thing?
Or? Definitely not an every year thing. That is like a once, it's like the Olympics, really.
She has to really
it's
be
like
motivated.
Once every 4 years.
Have your kids had them?
Yes.
Oh, we should
Sawyer
pressure
has.
Mom.
I'm trying to remember if Blake has.
Do it for the kids.
Sawyer. Yeah. Sawyer.
Here's the thing is I enjoy memories. Baking and I have tried to help mom before with cookie canes. Mm. They have to be shaped a very specific way.
Oh,
and
yeah.
They have to be iced a specific way.
Leah was not approved.
So
for
I am not approved for cookie cane duty.
It's like like a game show, like Chopped. Like you got kicked out.
I'm pretty sure she did get kicked
chopped.
Out of the kitchen.
We're sorry, but you're not going to make it to the next round.
You know the show on Netflix Nailed It?
Yes.
That's me.
Okay.
Just that's my baking style in general is just like tries and fails. I'm a Pinterest Nailed It type.
Whatever works for you.
But you know what? I can cook really well.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I can bake a monkey bread, and that's about it.
Hey.
All right. December 23rd is Festivus.
For the rest of us.
For the mm-hmm. rest of us. December 24th is National Eggnog Day.
No.
Pass.
I love eggnog.
Oh,
it's been
Matt.
A while. I feel like I need to try it as an adult.
Leah bought me some the other day.
No.
I haven't opened it up yet.
You just hate me.
I love eggnog. Maybe I'll have that and cookies tonight.
There you go. You dip.
Eggnog.
No.
All right.
Can't do it.
What is
you
it
don't
about
like
eggnog?
Fruit on your cheesecake, eggnog. But you like eggnog.
Eggnog's wonderful.
What is eggnog? Does it have actual
nastiness.
Eggs in it?
I feel like it's like...
It's a very specific taste.
It is.
It's a very specific taste and texture.
I looked it up online, like making your own. I've not attempted that, and I don't think I will.
It's like straight creamer.
I don't
creamer.
Think it's worth it, but
that's what it tastes like.
It looks like it's very difficult to make it at home.
That explains why I don't want to drink it. Michael likes it.
Rich, chilled, sweetened, dairy-based beverage. Traditionally made with milk, cream, sugar, egg yolks, and whipped egg whites.
Really good gross. For you.
Yeah. Have you ever heard of egg coffee?
No.
No.
So we went to a musical, and it was based in like Michigan, I think, or Wisconsin. I can't remember. But the whole time they talked about egg coffee, and I had to Google it. I'd never heard of it before. But it's a thing that people drink. It has eggs in it.
Yeah. Interesting.
But yeah.
Maybe it's like warm eggnog.
Honestly.
Maybe.
Ew.
I can get behind like worse. Any cocktail.
Yeah, it's on
with
a stove.
Like egg whites in it. Like I love the texture it adds like that.
Really?
Like,
learned something today.
So I bet egg coffee is good. December 25th is, of course, not Christmas Day, but National Pumpkin Pie Day.
That feels like it's on really? The wrong day.
Jesus, it should be Thanksgiving.
Jesus loved pumpkin pie.
Right. A lot of pumpkins grown, you know, where he was
born. Just around the table. Yay, nay, pumpkin pie.
Yay.
Sabrina?
Yay. I don't know. We had an incident with a child with pumpkin pie. I love it, but like, I just can't think about said incident. So, gotcha. Yeah. Next. Yeah.
I was going to ask questions, but I'm not going to now.
I think I'm right there with you, but mine was mac and cheese. So,
okay. Yeah.
I like pumpkin pie.
Yeah.
I love pumpkin pie.
Do you like whipped cream on your pumpkin pie?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think that's my favorite part.
I think that's the caveat is like, if you just hand me pumpkin pie with no whipped cream, I'm like, what are you doing?
Yeah. Our Thanksgiving, they had little tiny personal pumpkin pies.
With whipped cream.
So good.
They were so perfect and amazing. Yes. Yep.
And I will say, I feel like the mini pumpkin pie really fixed the, normally I feel like there's a lot of filling to like crust ratio.
It really did solve that issue.
It really solved it.
I think that's it. I need a lot of crust and a lot of whipped cream.
So, Bloomart, I know you're a Dairy Queen fan, so do you like their pumpkin pie blizzards?
He's
not going to venture into that world.
As much of a fan as I am of Dairy Queen, I actually don't go that much.
He just likes to talk about them.
Loves talking about a grill and chill.
Blizzards are good. I like them.
Ooh, grill and chill.
Anytime we pass a grill and chill, I'm always like, oh, look, Dairy Queen. And then we end up going to a different restaurant. So
his like and love is strictly theoretical.
Yeah.
You're talking about
I was going to say, I usually, you know me.
I do
chocolate,
know you.
Vanilla.
Yes.
No strawberry shakes. So typically when I get a milkshake, it's just
vanilla milkshake.
You don't really do a lot of blizzards even, do you?
No. I don't want all that stuff in there. I just want to be able to use a straw.
That's what blizzards are.
The point of the blizzard.
No, thank you. Gosh. I'm good with my regular milkshake.
He just wants a milkshake from Dairy Queen.
Yeah.
You can get milkshakes anywhere.
True.
Oh, now you make me want a blizzard.
That's what, whenever you said that, and then we're eating peppermint kisses. There's a place in Grandview, Indiana called Fat Daddy's. And they have a little Christmas tree blizzard.
Oh,
and it has bits like chunks of it,
like the Little Debbie Christmas trees.
Yes,
those are really good.
Though that's like I can't not buy like four boxes.
Yeah, because eat like four of them at a time.
Yes, they're so good.
Michael will make a Christmas tree dip.
Oh,
I've seen that.
Around Christmas.
It is like just straight pure
cream cheese and sugar.
Yes. Yeah, I'm
here for that.
I've also seen Michael stock his freezer with some of the Christmas tree flavored ice cream.
Oh, if we're talking local podcasts here, if you're shopping holiday foods and looking for the Christmas tree ice cream,
move on along.
Michael's cleared that one out for you.
I don't know if they still make it. Wasn't that a last year thing?
Oh, was that like a special one year thing?
I've seen it this year.
Oh, have you?
I have seen it this year.
Okay, I'll have to let Michael know.
Michael's cleared that out, and I've cleared out the eggnog.
You can have your eggnog.
Apparently he's not battling anybody for it.
No.
I will tell you, though, that Michael has figured out that you can freeze the Little Debbie Christmas trees.
Oh, okay. Hey, they're like better that way. They're so good. They're like,
he freezes them
frozen?
And then he eats them in like July.
So does he eat them frozen or is he love
them? No, he thaws them.
Okay.
I feel like
not smushy? Like really like.
No, because it's kind of weird. They really don't get hard. They just kind of get firmer.
Really?
They're probably refreshing in the middle of the summer.
He just wants to have one in the middle of the summer because you can't go and buy them right. in the middle yeah. of the summer.
It's genius.
Zebra cakes aren't the same. That's they're
no,
close.
No.
They're yeah. a but close yeah, second place.
They don't get hard. Like, you would expect them to, like, freeze, like, fully freeze, mm-hmm. and they really don't. There's not enough change their texture a whole lot.
I'm trying to decide if that sounds awesome or terrible.
I know.
It's not enough real stuff for it to freeze.
I
will tell
you, I have eaten a thawed, previously frozen Christmas tree, and it tasted fine, and I did not get sick.
Live to tell about it.
I don't think there's an expiration date.
I don't think so either.
No.
I think Little Debbie's last year.
The shelf life on those things is actually surprisingly short, though.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
It's surprisingly short.
Mm-hmm.
I would think they'd last forever.
I think they just put a date on it because they have to.
The FDA makes them.
They like want you to. It's like cookie dough people. Like they just want you to eat them faster. Oh, maybe.
It's kind of like how it's like bottled water has an expiration yeah. date. I'm like, seriously?
True.
So, Alec, we didn't get a pumpkin pie or an eggnog from you.
I have never tried eggnog. It just doesn't sound good. It's like, not. I don't want to drink an egg. Like, I just it think really, like, egg it, milk.
It's kind of
drinking
good.
It sounds
pretty
gross.
It's really good. And you do it, you put it in a shaker
no, you don't.
With ice.
No.
And it gets all frothy.
A little no. bourbon.
And, well, you can do it with bourbon, or you can just do just the eggnog if you're not trying to.
A little whipped
drink
cream
alcohol.
On top and a little cinnamon on top of that.
Yeah.
Chef's kiss.
Do love pumpkin pie. Okay. My grandfather has a huge garden, and he always makes like pumpkin pie from
so
like
those
his
are legit pumpkin pies.
Wow, that's real.
Yes. So okay. this year, I made our entire family's like Thanksgiving because my grandparents are getting to the age where they can't do that anymore, and I tried to make it from scratch, and it turned out horribly. So then I made a pumpkin tart. Instead, basically because the crust is always the hardest part.
Gotcha.
And this is like kind of gets that more crust than like pumpkin stuff. It's like super kind of like cheesecake crust, but like a lot of it with okay. like pumpkin pie filling. And that was really good.
You
so
probably
I can't recommend
like,
that.
I made pumpkin cheesecake muffins over Thanksgiving. You probably won't like that though because that's mixing.
No, I can get behind
pumpkin's
pumpkin.
A fruit.
It doesn't matter.
I thought it was a vegetable.
Oh, okay. It's a vegetable.
It's a gourd.
What's a gourd? I thought it was a fruit.
Who knows? I'll do pumpkin pie as long as it's got a good amount of whipped cream on it. So.
Yeah.
And that's an interesting idea.
And eggnog, I will raise my eggnog glass along with Matt.
It is a fruit. Eggnog.
Thank you, Steven.
Yeah, in moderation. I could not like kill a...
Is it really a fruit?
It's a fruit. Yeah.
Because it develops from seeds. A flower and contains seeds.
Wouldn't it be
it does have flowers, yeah.
From a botanist yeah. perspective, it is a fruit.
I wonder if it'd be possible
see,
to make a piece of cheesecake that has pumpkin pie kind of blended, like swirled throughout it. It's
but
like
if I just set a pumpkin pie on top of it, you wouldn't want it.
I don't know. I think I would eat it.
Yeah.
I like pumpkin pie.
I'll have to bring you some pumpkin cheesecake muffins in.
I'm excited to try them.
Okay. I'll do that.
Cool. Oh.
All right, December 26th is National Candy Cane Day.
Again, as we sit here eating candy cane kisses.
I was going to say,
smashed his back.
Candy right. cane kisses.
I don't think I would take just a candy cane right now and eat it. That was a little kid thing for me.
Yeah.
But
mm-hmm.
did
I will
you
say,
like, eat them until they got really sharp?
Yes.
Yes.
And like stab through
like,
your cheek?
Poke people.
Yeah.
Okay.
I didn't do that.
Have y'all ever tried other candy brand candy canes?
Those are the only ones I like.
Oh, like, yeah. like Jolly, Jolly Ranchers or Starburst
oh,
or
Skittles.
Sour Patch
one.
Kid ones.
I think, yes. I think you're right.
A&W
they
has one.
They like Sour Patch Kids, right. but they do have good flavors.
So then are they still candy canes?
Yes.
Or are they just,
I say yes.
Or are they just candy shaped like a cane? I guess that makes it a candy cane.
Candy shaped like a cane.
But I guess it still makes it a candy cane.
Oh, no.
Next.
Right. December 27th is National Leftovers Day.
Okay.
I don't know why you're skipping a day after Christmas right. for leftovers. But,
are you just
you know.
Ignoring all the leftovers?
Because you're eating
yeah,
candy canes.
You guys enjoy leftovers? I'm not a leftover person.
Some things
like
are.
Leftovers.
It depends on what it is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Leftover soup is better the next day than the
yep.
day of.
Sure.
Like I like
okay,
leftover
that's
soup.
Fair. Yeah. I'm thinking more like the holiday meal leftovers.
Oh,
though.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not
okay.
a big fan
I feel like
of
anytime somebody
leftovers.
Tries to like entice me, like, you know, mom always has leftovers at her house. And anytime she's like, do you want to come over for some leftovers? I'm like, no, absolutely not.
You deal with that mountain of food.
You should have said, do you want to come over for dinner and then serve me leftovers? And then it's too late. I'm already there.
Right.
Leftover dessert I can get behind. So that's the only way she ever gets me.
Our family did Thanksgiving at a new location and no one like nailed down who was bringing like plates and cups and stuff like that. So we ran out of plates before I got through the line. And so, oh, don't worry. I came, I figured I adapt. I used one of the like pans as my plate instead. And then when we got done, and the kids like never in those settings, they always go play and they never finish their plate. Yeah. So like, here, mom. So I just threw in my little pan and I was like, you guys got any tinfoil? And then I took home the whole box. They gave me the hardest time. My aunt came over, took a picture, and I'm like eating out of a pan, like the catering, like tossable container.
I love that. So love that.
We adapt. Yes. I loved it. I had lunch the next day.
That's awesome.
It's the best.
December 30th is the holiday we've all been waiting year for. National Bacon Day.
I'm totally on that. Lauren just captured the feeling of us all.
Break out your holiday bacon, everybody.
Ooh, yeah. That is an occasion for the holiday bacon.
I had bacon this morning with cinnamon rolls.
Nice.
Have we talked
about it? It's been a while since we've talked about holiday bacon.
Bacon. We had bacon at our employee breakfast the other day, and I asked Tiffany if that was considered Christmas holiday bacon.
I would say that was holiday bacon.
She said yes, absolutely.
It was really good.
Yeah, it was really good bacon.
Thank you. Tiffany for the gift.
Who's just been promoted to director of finance.
Yes, she has.
Yes.
I had a lot of bacon.
I did too. I actually went back and got a little bit more. Yeah.
We never run out.
Because they didn't have much when I went back. And
it was good.
Yeah.
All right. December 31st is Unlucky Day. It's your day to drop anything unlucky from the past year and go forward.
I like that thought.
And it's also Champagne Day.
Okay.
You like that thought too?
I like that thought too.
Yeah. I knew I needed to clarify that when I was like, I can't just put Unlucky Day on here and not know what that is.
It's also New Year's Eve.
It is also New Year's Eve.
Yeah.
I mean, National Champagne Day would be.
Right.
That's appropriate. That's much better than Pumpkin Pie Day on Christmas.
True story.
It feels like a mismatch. Maybe it's because like you serve pumpkin pie on both.
That's true.
And you can't really pin down a specific day for like,
because it's different.
Date.
Yeah.
Right. For Thanksgiving.
Oh, fair.
And she's a rock.
Steven, don't shorten that timing. Congratulations. You've gifted your way to the end of another episode. Please join us in 2 weeks during your next commute, cleaning session, etc. for our next episode, season 6, episode 1, the one with the new year, same gravy. Thanks to our behind-the-scenes pod squad, Stephen and Alec. I feel like you're less behind the scenes every episode, and we love having you. And thanks, of course, to all of you for continuing to listen and interact. If you're looking for ways to support Holiday World and Owopo, be sure to subscribe and tell all your theme park-loving friends and rate us if you have that option. We want to hear your feedback and would love to hear our listeners' voices instead of ours, so call us at 812-937-4401, then dial 8081 to get Stephen's long but informative instructions. Share your feedback with us at podcast@holidayworld.com or reach out to us on social media using the hashtag HoWoPo.
You've been listening to the official Holiday World Podcast.
Welcome back. Did you enjoy your flight?
A production of Holiday World and Splash and Safari in Santa Claus, Indiana. Check out the latest episodes at holidayworld.com/podcast. Thanks for taking a ride with us.
And please come back to see us again soon.